God gave the spirit.
Yeah.
See, if you come up to God, see, when he gave it again, what wrong with that? Which scripture tells the guy not to give
out
the spirit again?
It doesn't say, because I didn't take up his spirit.
Alright, I'll show you that.
Hold on,
we're ecclesiastic. We're show you. We're show you why you have this spirit. We have a show on this spirit. Go on, brother.
See, you know, Jesus, we have a show on this spirit. Ecclesiastes 12 and 7.
Right.
Then shall the dust return to the earth as it was.
Right.
And the spirit shall return unto God who gave it.
It's you what?
Return unto God.
Said so come from there. The spirit come from where?
We don't know spirit. We say God gave spirit.
So hold on. I ask a question now. When the spirit is there, where God is now, what happened to that spirit? Yeah.
Judgment.
You sure?
Yes.
See? Where is the judgment? Where is the judgment?
The second coming?
So the second coming?
Read Revelation, the three angels mentioned, and I saw that the angel of heaven having the everlasting gospel, preach unto every kingdom, nation, tongue, and people. Fear God.
Brother, I'm asking one question. Now, remember that Jesus said, I'm asking one question.
Go ahead, bro.
It is appointed unto man once to die.
Yes.
Right?
After death.
We the man you're going to do fast. The girl here, I was trying to raise from the dead.
Who?
Is she still alive? The girl that was raised from the dead, because she dead already and she was resurrected, you know.
Right.
Is she still alive today?
She dead again.
Okay. But you said it's appointed unto man once to die.
Remember, Christ came here to
that's a contradiction.
Christ came here to do something no man could have done.
Elijah did it.
Why Elijah? Christ came to the earth, Christ came here as a lamb to the slaughter, right? Because he came to die for our sins. For the wages of sin is death. So guess what? Because our fallen race sinned, you had to add pure blood to be shed for the remission. For the remission. So Christ came here for that reason. But while he was here, he had things to get done. Just like how he raised, man, what's your name?
That's your way to understand. That's your way to understand. See? That's your way to understand.
I'm not losing.
No, that's your way to understand. See? Just start from the top. That's your way to understand.
It's Ecclesiastes 1 and verse 4.
Right.
One generation passes.
So one generation passes away.
And another generation coming. But the earth abided forever.
But the earth abided forever. So the earth never ever be totally destroyed. Yeah.
No, the Bible says, "Thou shalt not be left here, one stood upon another shall left."
Structures on the earth are getting destroyed, on the earth itself.
Yeah, then I'm going to go up
there.
I'm going to go up there.
Alright.
Because it's our next nation.
Because
someone
else.
Good.
Right.
So the sun is always up, you know.
Hold on, brother. Hold on, brother. Hold on, brother. Sure. Right.
The sun ariseth and the sun goeth down.
Right.
And he ascended to his place where he arose.
So after approximately 12 hours, the sun come back. Well, you know, we call that process. It's called a cycle.
Yeah.
All right. Okay. So at one point you see it, at one point you don't.
You know the sun don't move, bro.
We're not going to that.
All right. Verse 6.
Go on.
The wind goeth toward the south,
right,
and turneth about unto the north. It whirleth about continually, right, and the wind returneth again according to its circuit.
Return. The same breeze that blow past us today. When it go around the planet, it's going to blow past us again. You understand? The same breeze. Go around and it come up around.
Verse 7.
Hold on.
All the rivers.
Hold on. Stop.
Nobody will belong to this generation now come back into this generation again. See, they have to wait till when that generation die off and come back in the trip. Okay, you have four generations.
I find out generation.
Four generations. Listen. Four generations exist. In existence. See? Okay, listen. You see, this generation now, this generation was 3 to 4 generations ago.
This was 3 to 4 generations ago?
Yes. That generation.
So you're Adam.
That generation.
You're Adam.
All of us was there.
No! No.
All of us are there.
It is appointed and two man wants to die. No. It is appointed and two man wants to die. Hold on, man. Wait, read. Go and get this straight. It is appointed and two man wants to
so
die.
So, little girl.
And after death comes the judgment.
Little girl.
Lazarus.
Listen, little girl.
Yeah, that little girl.
I'm ready to stay up here now. Yeah. I don't know what it means.
Hold on. Remember, when Christ came on the face of the earth, he was born from a woman, he was subject to death, right? So, but he had duties to perform because when he was tempted, let me finish. So, if you're the son of God, come on, repent this one, return to spirit.
And if you want to do reincarnation,
we are talking about the word death and resurrection.
Yeah.
And I said, why? If the little girl did and resurrected. And guess what? If they want to see
him. What happened to Samuel?
When
Samuel died, what happened to Samuel?
See?
When Saul.
Saul inquired from the witch what happened to Samuel.
He was arose from his sleep. And he what? He come back to come talk to Saul.
So being outside flesh, brother, no means he can't come back.
So don't be real.
Demons are real. But when people die, hold on, when people die, people don't come back as the same person. You come back as somebody else in the future.
Alright,
you can't. You can't. There's nothing you can tell me to believe in that.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
27. 19.
Why did the Lord say, like, John the Baptist? Why the Lord say?
Why
the Lord say that John the Baptist is alive? No.
Read, said Matthew 1.
Calm down.
Why did the Lord say? Because first of all, there's a prophet that said. There's a prophecy in the Old Testament. There's a prophecy in the Old Testament that said that Elijah must come back before the great and terrible day of the Lord. See? Malachi, Malachi 4 and verse 5.
I will send you Elijah the prophet before the coming of the great and dreadful day of the Lord. and he shall turn the heart of the fathers to the children, and the heart of the children to their fathers, lest I come and smite the earth with a curse.
This was written hundreds of years after Elijah and his translation, back in the heavens by the fire of the air. And Malachi, by the word of the Lord, said that I will send Elijah before the great and terrible. Elijah is going to come back. Right? The scripture we read earlier on. See, they are fucking asking. Why must the Christ say that Elijah must be come? This is why he said that, because of the prophecy. And then the Lord said to them, Elijah is come, and Elijah is John the Baptist. Why did the Lord say that Elijah is John the Baptist?
No,
I'm going to ask you a question. Why did the Messiah say that Elijah is John the Baptist? That's it. Just think about it. Because Jesus said, no, really, how are you going up? He said, Elijah must come before the great and dreadful day of the Lord. He must come to carry the heart of the fathers back to the children, and the children to the fathers. Right? So, who come and fulfill that? The Lord tell you in Matthew, I'm going to read that John the Baptist is Elijah, which was supposed to come. That's what the scripture says. He never go in the corner, he said shit. He said this is Elijah, which was supposed to come.
He said, if you can receive it, you can receive it.
So, why I think about that?
Why give them scripture? I'm begging them, come and need them.
You have a priest up in a loop, where sure you said the prophecy gets fulfilled.
Which prophecy is fulfilled?
The same one who read, you know, in a while.
But, you know, the one question I asked them,
the word reincarnation is not in the Bible.
The process is there. The word reincarnation is describing the process, brother. Yes, sir. Listen. This is what you're doing. Telling you the process. See? I'm going to tell you this is a word to describe the process. And the word is reincarnation, brother. Simple. Are you saying the word not in the Bible or the process is not in the Bible? What are you saying?
So what if the word is in the Bible?
The process is there!
But the ability
to word only describe the process, brother! See, none of the English words that we use, not in the original scripture, brother. None of them. See? So if I use logic, I say because an English word in the Bible.
See? In Hebrew or it was Bible written in Hebrew, right? Or Greek.
Yeah, Hebrew and Greek.
Okay, good. If that when the word Why if a word synonymous or a phrase synonymous to reincarnate? In the Bible.
What's wrong with that?
Because the word reincarnate don't
in
the Bible.
You still don't get what you're saying. Where the process is not on fire.
The process is there.
Just read
the reincarnation mean. Read the reincarnation mean from the dictionary. A rebirth of a soul in a new human body.
Yeah. You know that.
Alright.
Okay.
So did the Bible not say that Elijah was born as John the Baptist?
Yes.
Isn't that a human being born in our next body? Another
soul.
One soul. Can you just say, motherfucker, we're going to read it plain and simple again. If you don't worry, you. Okay, so you have to agree that Elijah was born as John the Baptist.
You don't believe the Bible. Show me something when I go to a site.
Point out something to make everything you do, right? If you want to be a doctor, you have to go to the process of going.
Because there's nothing on the face of the earth to know what you're saying.
So the 12 tribe of Israel only come from the Western Hemisphere. And what's the thing about the
These are the places that Israel predominantly
dwells. So what about Australia, Indonesia?
Genesis 10 and 1.
Right.
Now these are the generations of the sons of Noah.
Right.
Shem, Ham, and Japheth.
Right.
And unto them were born sons. Unto them were sons born after the flood.
Right.
The sons of Japheth, Gomer, and Magog, and Madai, and Javan, and Tubal, Meshech, and Tyrus. And the sons of Gomer, Ashkenaz, and Rifat, and Togama. And the sons of Japhet, Elisha, and Tarshish, Kittim, Dodanim.
So here the Bible, I name the nation them. Why nations them don't name them name them today? These are nations being named. Yeah? So why is it that so today? Why the nations have a different name today?
Different people come to
Does that change the fact that the nations are who they are in the sight of God?
inclination or what?
Regardless of my, if God said this man, name James.
Yes.
And you say name John.
Yes.
See? That makes a difference to God said this man name James.
Not really, it makes a difference. But look.
Can you can't change what God said?
Alright. So weird. Yes. Alright, there's a Jamaican in the Bible.
Man call him them name here.
Listen to me, there's a Jamaican in the Bible.
Yeah.
Right. They agree with that. But what about Cuban?
Because man call him them name there.
So, it's the same thing we are coming back to. If there's a man call them, name them.
You don't make it right. These are the names that God give them. These are the names that man give them.
Hold on, you know.
How
did Noah say? Judas.
The American Negro. The Bible tell you where American Negro.
The
Bible tell where Judas are.
You
hear
the Bible tell
her
that?
You hear the Bible tell
her that?
What the Bible say? What can the Bible tell
her? Read the Bible from me, please. Give me the description. Give me the description. Please.
Genesis 49.
Genesis what?
Genesis what? It's a prophecy, brother.
Genesis 49.
Genesis 49 chapter?
Continue. Genesis 49 and 1. And Jacob called unto his sons and said, gather yourselves together that I may tell you what shall befall you in the last days.
You have most of that
befall me.
Alright,
you see
the
Bible
talk? You're
in
the last days, alright?
Gather yourselves together and hear, ye sons of Jacob, and hearken unto Israel their father. Verse 8. Judah, thou art he whom thy brethren shall praise.
This is about the last bit. Brethren
shall praise Judah. Alright?
Is that we?
No.
So West Indians.
So we are the Benjamin.
We are part of the West Indies. So we are the West Indies.
We are Benjamin.
Yeah, we are part of the West Indies.
Yes.
And everybody knows.
When I listen,
I'm American. 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 I'm American